Very much for this interview to the Greek public television. On the name issue, it seems that there is a positive momentum for solution on both sides. What changed? And give us your sense, if you think this momentum could reflect in the negotiations.
Well, first of all, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to speak and to talk again about the name issue. Yes, there's a different atmosphere now. And I think it's come about by a number of things. There's a new government in Skopje that is very interested in resolving this issue. I think the Greek government also recognizes that this is a good thing to solve, that it would make a very positive step in for Greek foreign policy in the region to resolve this long-standing issue with a northern neighbor. So therefore, I think in both countries there's a positive momentum. I think the people in both countries are ready to hear some solutions that are consistent with national interests, but also have some element of compromise that would solve the problem. I think there's a view also of concern for issues in the region. The migrant issue was a jolting event there. Issues of terrorism and instability in the region also lead people to think, isn't it time to resolve these types of differences? I think Greece, having emerged from some very serious economic financial troubles, is now in a much more positive state in terms of its economy and should be playing a more significant leadership role in the region. So I think all these things have led people to think, let's try to settle this matter in a friendly way.
Now, in the meeting in New York with the representatives of both countries, are you planning to present them a new name or a name that it was rejected in the past and now the two sides could consider it with a new positive approach?
Well, of course, to the extent I give some ideas, I'll give them to the representatives next week when we meet on the 17th. I can't give you what my ideas right now. But I would say this, that we've gone more than 20 years discussing this issue, and many of the ideas have been put on the table. But there's always a new way of looking at things, slightly new dimensions. Therefore, I think people will look at the matter in somewhat different light. Of course, there's nothing totally new. I think I said this once before. There's no new magic in the issue. We know what the problems are. We know the point of view in Athens. We know the point of view in Skopje. So there are obviously elements that have come in the past.
So you will present the name and ideas that you have already negotiated in the past?
Over the years, I've made various suggestions. Sometimes one country has found them useful. Sometimes the other country has found them useful. And I think that what I would try to do is take elements that I've heard from both sides. Now, I haven't given any ideas in the last few years. It hasn't really been appropriate given what was going on. But I think now we have some good negotiators there. Ambassador Vasilakis is experienced and knows this issue very well. Ambassador Namovsky is also a very effective diplomat, and their colleagues. So we're going to try some ideas.
Mm-hmm. In media, on both sides, we have seen lately different names, always with a modifier. North Macedonia, Nova Macedonia. Mm. Are you planning to present them only one name? And what type of modifier?
I'd love to talk to you about it, but I think it's a little premature today, given the fact that the meeting is next week. And I don't think it's appropriate for me to start talking about particular names. There's a lot of attention to some type of modifier, and that's what many of us have been thinking about. But I don't want to, at this stage, give any ideas. I think what I want to do is concentrate on the basic issue, and that is the need to reach a conclusion to these talks, and to have people in both countries focused on reaching a solution.
Besides the name, what other issues are important? Could the two sides work on solving these issues with talks?
I've always said that nothing would give me greater pleasure than to be irrelevant and to have both sides reach an agreement without a mediator. I think there's been a lot of discussion in the last few years about the relationship of the two countries, and under the leadership of Foreign Minister Kotsias, there have been a series of confidence-building measures that the other side has been very instrumental also in helping to develop. And I think this has created a better atmosphere. I think that the rhetoric of a historical nature that sometimes appeared to be provocative has been toned down and, in fact, has largely disappeared. I think that's very important. And I think in both countries, there's a forward-looking approach to the relationship rather than a backward-looking approach. And as someone has said, it wasn't me, but someone said, we have a choice of moving rapidly into the 21st century, or we have a choice of going back to the 19th century. I think for the young people in both countries, moving forward is very much superior to moving backwards. So if you have a feeling that we're moving forward in the region, we're going to be cooperative, we're going to work together, we're going to all be in the EU together, we're all going to be in NATO together, we're going to solve problems together, then you look at this in a way that it can be resolved.
So what other issues are sensitive for both countries?
Yeah. There are ancillary issues besides the issue of the name, that is the usage, that is issues of identity that are of great concern in the northern neighbor, and one has to be extremely sensitive about that. There are concerns in Greece also about historical issues of appropriation of historical heritage, of school book issues that also need ultimately to be addressed. So these group of ancillary issues that we know about are important, but I think there are solutions to them, and two friendly neighbors can resolve them if we get the basic issue resolved first.
In Greece, on the name issue, we have differing views within the government, within the opposition parties, within the society. Do you think when the crucial moment for decision will come, will be a real will for solution?
You know, I've been working as a diplomat with Greece for, believe it or not, 40 years.
Many
more
years.
Than 40 years. I have two rules Rule number one is never comment on Greek politics. I'm not going to comment on Greek politics. Obviously, Greece is a democracy and a very lively democracy, and the various political groups and political leaders have points of view. I think Greece is lucky to have a lot of very serious leaders, I'm confident that if the government of Greece finds a solution here that satisfies them, hopefully people will look at it with great seriousness and hopefully be supportive.
Mr. Nimes, thank you very much for this interview.
Thank you.